So I know it probably don't mean crap to some people, but, you know, some of these people around the world, like this particular person in Bolivia, sees the reality of what's going on. And let's listen to what he has to say a little tiny bit here.
Today is a dark day in the history of this council. Three permanent members of the council have taken the decision to breach the Charter of the United Nations and take military action against the sovereignty and territorial integrity of another member state of our organization.
What he means by that is the United States, Israel, and the United Kingdom decided that they are above the law and they can do whatever they want and not follow any of international law or any other law, but their own decree is what he is basically saying in a civil, kind manner.
Bolivia wishes to clearly and categorically express its condemnation of the use of chemical weapons or chemical substances as weapons, as this is unjustifiable and criminal wherever it happens, by whomever. It's, their use is a serious crime against international law, international peace and security. Those responsible for committing such terrible and criminal acts must be identified,
absolutely,
investigated, prosecuted, and punished in the most rigorous way possible. Bolivia continues to demand a transparent and impartial investigation to determine who are the culprits. But in addition to that, as the topic of this meeting is the fact that three permanent members of the council, as I said, have used force in breach of the United Nations Charter. You cannot combat the alleged violation of international law by violating international law.
Or you're a criminal. Basically, this is like a mafia hit. These are mafia-style tactics that's going on. It's just like the cops nowadays, shoot first and we'll ask questions later. You know, we're unfortunately, you know, I don't live in a high tower, I'm gonna remind everybody, and I'm just swimming in this pool just like the rest of you. But we do have a very serious situation that is going on. And the United States and the UK is being directed and baited by that little country in the East called Israel. And the problem is they think that they're above the law, including the people in this country, which is being totally on this side of this problem. And if they're not, because guess what? American policy has nothing to do with running somebody's foreign policy. And yes, each nation's sovereign state, we have no legal right to go and do what we're doing to other people around the world, let alone who the F decided that America was going to be the police of the world and decide the fate of everyone. And it seems like that is also our little friend in the East's mindset too. Because that we can see that the intervention with these little maggots all the time that are causing these problems, they're always at the center stage of this problem, or they're the poking in the back or in the neck or pointing the fingers, screaming all the time. Well, a lot of the people in the world community sees what's going on. And as long as that Americans continue to believe this hogwash that comes out of this mindset that we have been living in, nothing's going to change. I mean, we even have a propaganda machine that helps spew this agenda, this narrative that comes right out of Hollywood, which is a part of this cabalah of problems. Yeah. And unfortunately, we are being manipulated highly in this country. And it's a sad thing, because I truly don't think Americans, if they really, truly, deeply understood what was truly going on, they would be fit to be tied. Oh, yes, they would. they would be actually so angry, they wouldn't know what to do about it. Yes, they would. They'd be so angry. And it would cause a big catastrophic blowback in this country. And it would cause horrendous blowback for our little friends in the Middle East. Yeah. That has a big wall around them. Are they prisoners or are they keeping people out? I don't know what the deal is on that. But we see, we know, the people see. And we see that that is a big problem. And a lot of people are really disrupted and very angry about how that little country is manipulating this country and using a narrative to believe the lies that are being perpetrated by this group of people. And unfortunately, let me go back to this.
Bolivia.
Está sorprendida.
Is surprised
por el hecho de que
by the fact that the permanent members of the Council, given that they have a greater responsibility for maintaining international peace and security, have decided to bypass the United Nations when it suits them. They defend multilateralism as long as it serves them, and then they simply discard it. When it is no longer in their interest, they're no longer attached to multilateralism.
So you can see other people see what's going on, and they know it's wrong. They know, and what are they going to do? I mean, when you got the biggest bullies on the block, what are you going to do? The only thing you can do is just call it out and hopefully enough people wake up and stop these bullies on the block. Yeah, because that's what these guys are, bullies. They're world bullies. And it's got to stop. Everybody, really? Come on, man. And we're funding this. And we're supporting this. This is insanity, ladies and gentlemen, at its finest hour.